All of a sudden, the radio stopped working, and then that flooding just disappeared. A crazy forest. Is this who I think it is?
Casey, say hello to Alan Wake. Mr. Wake, this is Special Agent Alex Casey. He'll escort you to our car. Casey, I'll meet you there, right after I take a look around. If the flooding's receded, there might be evidence we missed earlier.
Okay. See you there.
Alex Casey? How? Am I still... Is this the dark place?
Should look around. With the flooding gone, could be further clues out there. Yes, the flooding disappeared very suddenly. I wonder if there's any connection to the overlap.
Moving on.
To Nightingale.
It's a bit of a hike to the car, wait. Get you there.
A creepy twig sculpture? A locked box. Is that the cult of the tree symbol on it? Notes and ammo. Looks like they're tools of the trade. The cult doesn't see their victims as people. There's something written here. A poem? Or a riddle? Reminds me of the nursery rhymes I read to Logan when she was little. A little clothespin doll. Perfect weird souvenir for Logan. Another one of those rhymes. Rest easy, buddy. Oh. Doesn't make sense. Nah. No. Keep trying. The cult is leaving supplies around for themselves. Wonder what's inside. I should take a look around for a way to open this thing.
The writer went into the lake, banished the dark presence. Taken still lurked in the woods. The dark place receded. The current pulled back those with darkness inside, into the lake. Nightingale was there, one of them. The dark presence, Jagger had taken him. The witch had stolen his heart. They sank beneath the waves. The dark place, wandering in the shadows, muttering to themselves, "It's dark. I'm lost. Where am I? Who am I? I can't remember. It's cold. Premium cabins for rent in Bright Falls. Who said that? Can you hear me? I need help. Please, stop this. What did I do? You must dig it out." Their shape shifted. Echoes of the writer's dreams. Fading in, fading out. The next story and the story after that. The writer was writing again. He'd been on the trail of the writer forever. The writer he despised. Hemingway, Bukowski, Wake. "I'll get you. I'll find you. I'll make you pay. You're in over your head." He descended into the tunnels from the dark city, into the ocean of darkness. Next stop, Caldera Street Station. Something, a presence, rumbled. Not a train. Shadows shifted on the platform. The writer's cult waited for him there. The cult of the word. A cultist leaned close. "I carry his words close to my chest now. You're not allowed in the lake until he says otherwise." He'd be caught. Murdered. They got him. They didn't get him. He was reborn out of hate. He was there. But he was risen. Sent to find the light switch up from the lake that was not the lake.
reached the car, Anderson. How's it going down there?
I think I'm done here. I'll meet you at the parking lot.
Warning. Activity detected. AWE. Event in progress. Cauldron Lake. What's an AWE?
Casey, what exactly does the FBC do?
After New York, when I started looking for our friend here, their name came up. I pushed them for any files they had on him, but got stonewalled. They have a reputation of showing up for weird shit. They have a presence here, and now we find our writer. How about that?
Ready to go?
Mr. Wake, we're taking you back to our field office in Bright Falls. You can freshen up there, and then we'll talk properly.
Hey, Mom. Before you say anything, I'm totally fine. Don't freak out. Dad shouldn't have even texted you.
Logan? No one texted me. What's going on?
I'm totally fine. I slipped, that's all. God, it's not the end of the world.
Put your father on the phone.
Okay. Dad, it's Mom.
Don't worry, hon. Logan slipped in the shower and bumped her head. She has a slight concussion, but I'm keeping an eye on her. Lucky I heard her fall. She could have drowned.
Jesus, David. Why didn't you call?
I tried. It didn't go through. She's fine, really. But what about you? You sound stressed.
No, it's, just a weird case, that's all.
Well, if you need a hint, my years of board game victories tell me Colonel Mustard did it.
I'll keep an eye out for him. Love you, Dave.
Love you too, honey. Want to say bye to Logan?
Just tell her I love her. Bye for now. Anyone you'd like us to reach out to, Mr. Wake? You've been gone a long time.
No. They'd be in danger. It'll come for me.
Okay, let's talk about something else. Robert Nightingale. Do you know him? You were both here in 2010.
The Dark Presence got him back then. That's the last time I saw him. 13 years.
Tell us about the pages. You had what looks like a title page with you. Return. Is this the name of the story on these pages? The writer's name has been scratched out pretty violently, but your name can still be made out underneath.
Scratched out. Yeah. Scratch.
Did you write these pages, Mr. Wake?
I'm trying to remember. It's a crazy jumble, like a nightmare. It doesn't make sense.
Waking up in places with no memory of how I'd gotten there. It was out of control. I didn't need another mugshot in the fucking tabloids. Had I already done the show? Was that a recording?
To see you, Alan. This must be an exciting time for you. Tell me, does it ever get old?
Sorry, does what get old?
Publishing a new book. Are you okay there, my friend? You look like you've been cooped up in the writer's room for a few too many years.
This is exactly how I feel.
You know, I've waited so long to get my hands on the sequel to Departure. You left us on quite the cliffhanger. We've all been dying to know what "it's not a lake, it's an ocean" really means.
You and me both.
Well, our wait is over. Your new book, Initiation, hits the shelves tomorrow.
What?
That's exactly what every reader will be asking. This book is mind-bending. It's so cerebral. I mean, how would you describe it? An auto-fictional thought experiment? A horror story? A postmodern detective story?
Wait. This isn't right. I haven't written anything.
He's so humble.
Okay, you got me. Good prank, very funny. But yeah, sad to say, I've not written this. I'd remember if I'd written a book, right?
Or maybe it was written by your evil double. Well played, man! That is spot on! Playing the role here! Pretending the world of the book overlaps our own? That's very meta indeed. You see, Initiation tells the story of a fictional writer named Alan Wake, who is trapped in a nightmare, desperately trying to find the manuscript of a novel he has forgotten he has written. The book is set in New York, but it might not be New York at all. He is tormented by his dark doppelganger and guided by visions of a fictional detective he has written. That's right, Alex Casey is in this book as well.
I guess we'll just keep doing this the whole show. The joke's on me.
But isn't that what you sign up for with autofiction? No, but seriously, I found the structure of the reality you build in the book fascinating. It reminded me of The Matrix. I mean, the writer is physically in his writer's room, trapped there, and he projects himself out to this dark dream of New York through the story he is writing. Like astral projection. Did I get that right?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Go on. I should be taking notes here. This is great stuff.
Notes to that other Alan Wake in that room writing this as we speak? Are we all in your story, Alan? Wow. No, I wish you every success with your new book, Alan. I hope it's as successful as your best-selling Alex Casey series. Initiation hits the shelves tomorrow. After this, I'm sure we'll all be eagerly awaiting the culmination of this hero's journey trilogy of yours. A book called Return, perhaps. Man, thank you for one of the strangest interviews of my entire career, Alan. All this talk of meta-narratives. Expecting to disappear once this scene ends.
Hello? I'm losing it. Something's not right here. I needed to get home. To Alice. What the hell was that interview? Some kind of joke? Initiation? I never wrote a book called Initiation. This felt like a bad dream. Could make a good horror story. Old Gods of Asgard. That name sounded familiar. was something in the studio with me. I had to get out. Of a memory surfaced about riding here for countless days. A plot board for mapping out a story. On the index cards, the nightmare that just happened to me. A summary of the story so far, but other notes as well. Warnings. I had written them. I couldn't remember what it all meant. The name Scratch filled me with dread. I could trust these words. I had to act on them. You must write to escape.